Welcome students, myself Mehboob Pasha, and today in this session we will continue with the problems of exercise 2.1 of rational numbers. Students, look at the first question of first main. Okay, so here what they have given? Using appropriate properties, find. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to find the value of this expression using appropriate properties. Okay, so first step, what we will do? So we will take this first step as it is. Okay, so look at your students, what we have done, we have taken the question as it is. Okay, so now look at your students. So here three groups can be done. Okay, so why we have done three groups means, so look at these two groups. Okay, so look at these two groups. Here 3/5 is common now, so don't worry about the sign. Here plus is there, here minus is there, don't worry about it. So why we have done groups means, look at here some numbers are common now. In these groups some numbers are common. Okay, so what we will do now, we will write this plus 5/2 after this term. Okay, so we will write plus 5/2 after this term. So here we will using commutative property. Okay, so if we add a plus b or b plus a, you will get same answer. No, so here we will use commutative property. We will shift this one after this. Okay students, look at here, what we have done in this step, we have written this plus 5/2 after this term. Okay, so here a plus b or a plus b is equals to b plus a. If we add a plus b or b plus a, the result will be same. So here in this step we have used commutative property. So now look at here, these terms or expressions is having 3/5 as common. No, it is having 3/5 as common. So look at only this much. Okay, so it is of the form a into b minus a into c. This term up to here, no, it is of the form a into b minus a into c. So what is that? It is a distributive property. Okay, so a into b minus a into c is what? A into b minus c, distributive property. So look at here students, as in these two terms, no, as 3/5 is common, don't worry about the sign. As 3/5 is common, we will take 3/5 as it is common. Okay, so we will take 3/5 as common. Now from this term I have taken 3/5, so outside, so what is remaining? Minus 2/3. No, so we'll write minus 2/3. Now look at here, from this term I have taken only 3/5 outside, so what is remaining? Minus 1/6. No, so minus 1/6. Okay, so write this as it is. So what we have used here, distributive property, no, that is a into b minus c. This step, what, which property we have used? We have used distributive property. So look at here students, what I have done here, I have written this step once. Okay, so I have written this step once again. So you need not to write this step once again, I just written to make you better understand. Okay, so look at here, now in this step we have used which property? Distributive property. So now look at here students, 3 and 6 is there. Minus 2/3, minus 1/6. What is the LCM of 3 and 6? I will write directly. Okay, the LCM of 3 and 6 is what? 6. The LCM of 3 and 6 is 6. And to make 3 as 6, we need to multiply 2 and here also 2. And as LCM is 6, no, here denominator is 6, so need not to multiply anything or you need to multiply 1. Now, minus 2 into 2, minus 4. Minus 1 into 1, minus 1. So, write this one as it is. Okay. So, 5 by 2. Next. 3 by 5. Now, minus 4 minus 1 will be minus 5 by 6. And this will be what? Plus 5 by 2. So, this can be written as, okay, so look at here. This bracket represents what? Multiplication. This bracket represents what? Multiplication. Okay, so it can be written like this. Now, okay, so look at here. 3 ones are 3. As there is a multiplication sign in between these two numbers, we can cancel. 3 ones are 3. 3 twos are 6. Okay, so now 5 ones are 5. 5 ones are 5. Okay, if it is having negative sign also, we can cancel here. 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. So what is remaining now? 1 into minus 1. This is minus 5 now, so it will be minus 1. 1 into minus 1 will be minus 1. Next, 1 into 2 will be 2. 1 minus 1 divided by 2. So now, plus, this is 5 by 2 now, so write here as it is. Okay, so 5 by 2. So look at your students, what I have done here, I have taken this, I have written this stuff once, okay? I have taken this stuff once again. So now, look at these two numbers. These are having same denominator now. These are having same denominator. So the LCM of these two numbers is what? Two, denominator is what? 2 only, okay? So the LCM of 2 and 2 is what? 2 only. So we will write as it is. Minus 1 plus 5. Minus 1 plus 5 will be what? 4 by 2. And here, it can be cancelled. 4, 2 ones are 2 are. So what can be done? 2. Okay. What is the value of this question? That is minus 2 by 3 into 3 by 5 plus 5 by 2 minus 3 by 5 into 1 by 6. What is the value of this question? When we solve that question, we will get the answer as 2. So now, we will solve second question. Okay. So what is given here? 2 by 5 into minus 3 by 7 minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2 plus 1 by 14 into 2 by 5. So what is the first step? We will take this question as it is. Okay. 2 by 5. Okay. So what we have done here? We have taken the question as it is. So now, we will make these three groups, okay? We'll make these three groups. So look at here, students. What is common in these three groups? So look at here. In this group, 2 by 5. And here also, 2 by 5. So 2 by 5 is common now. 2 by 5 is common in this group. So what we will do now? So now, we will write this term after this, okay? So we will write this term after this term. So here also we will be using commutative property. That is, if we add a plus b or b plus a, the value will need not change. Okay. Okay, students, look at here. What we have done in this step, we have shifted or we have written this step after this term. Okay, so we have done this term after this one. So here what we have used? Commutative property. So now, look at here, these two terms. Okay, so look at here. So here what is common in these two? 2 by 5 is common, no? 2 by 5 is common in these two. So here, it is of the form a into b plus a into See, it is of the form A into B plus A into C. What is that? It is a distributive property, no? So A into B plus A into C is what? A into B plus C. So now what we'll do? As 2 by 5 is common, we will take outside it. 2 by 5. Okay. So now what is remaining in this term? If I take 2 by 5 outside, minus 3 by 7 is remaining, no? So minus 3 by 7 plus. From this term, if I take 2 by 5 outside, what is remaining? 1 by 14. So 1 by 14. Okay. So now 2 by 5 into 3 by 7 plus 1 by 14. So write this one as it is. That is minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2. So here in this step, which property we have used? Distributive property. Okay, so right here. In this step, which property we have used? We have used distributive property. Look at your students. So what is there? 2 by 5 into 3 by 7 plus 1 by 14 minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2. So now what we will do? We will find the LCM of these two numbers. Okay. So here LCM of 7 and 14 is what? 14. Okay. So LCM of 7 and 14 is what? 14 only. And here 7 is there. To make it 14, you need to multiply 2. And here also 2. As here LCM is 14, you need not to multiply anything or multiply 1. Now, minus 3 into 2 will be minus 6 plus 1 into 1 will be 1. Now, minus 1 by 6 into 3 by 2. So now students, look at here. As there is multiplication sign in between, you can cancel here. 3 1s are 3 2s. Okay, so now 2 by 5. This minus 6 plus 1 will be what? Minus 5. Next, 14. Minus 5 divided by 14. Minus 1 into 1 will be 1 by 2 2s are 4. So this can be written like this. As bracket represents multiplication sign, it can be written. Okay, so now look at here, 5 1s are 5, 2 1s are 2, 7s are 14, okay. So here, minus is there. So 1 into minus 1 will be minus 1, 1 into 7 will be 7. Next, minus 1 by 4. What we have got? We have got minus 1 by 7, minus 1 by 4. Okay, dear students, what we have got? We have got minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 7. Now we need to find the LCM of these two. What is LCM of 7 and 4? 28. Okay. The LCM of 7 and 4 is what? 28. And to make it 28, you need to multiply 4 to this 7. And here also 4. And to make it 28, you need to multiply 7. And here also you need to multiply 7. Now, 1 into minus 1 into 4 will be minus 1 into 4 will be minus 4. Okay, so now here minus 1 into 7 will be 7. So now look at your students. Minus 4 minus 7 is what? Minus 4 minus 7 is what? Minus 11. Okay, so minus 11 divided by 28. Okay, so this is the answer. So when you solve this question, okay, so when you solve this question, you will be getting answer as minus 11 by 28.